A very good morning, dear children. Today we are going to see chapter number 12 of general science, that is simple machines. Now observe and discuss. In the following pictures, certain devices are used to accomplish certain tasks more easily. Name the devices and discuss how they help. So in the above pictures, we can see needle, wheelbarrow, bottle opener, nail cutter, pulley, and an axe. All of these are simple machines. Due to all these simple machines, we are using for doing many activities, and due to that, our work becomes easy. Needle helps in stitching and joining the two separate parts of the clothes. Wheelbarrow helps to pull heavy loads of luggage easily. Bottle opener is used to open the seat gap easily. Nail cutter is used for trimming the nails easily and safely. Pulley helps to lift the weights easily. We can pull up the things efficiently with the help of a pulley. An axe is used for chopping the wood. So all these are the simple machines, and we are using all these simple machines in our day-to-day life. Now let us see the definitions of machines. Devices which are used to get more work done in less time and less effort are called machines. There are two types of machines, that is simple machine and complex machines. First of all, we will see definition of simple machines. Machines having one or two parts and simple and easy structure are called simple machines. Now, next topic is, can you take? Observe the machines shown in the following pictures. For what purposes are they used? Can you name some other machines of this kind? In the above pictures, we can see a mixer, sewing machine, bicycle, scooter, and a wheelchair used for a patient. Mixer is used for grinding the food atoms and is widely used in kitchens. Scooter is a two-wheeler. It can take us to desirable place in short time. Bicycle is a vehicle which does not require any fuel and can take us to short distances. It works on our muscular energy. Sewing machine helps us to stitch the cloth in a short time, then less labor and with great efficiency. Invalid persons and sick patients cannot walk on their own. They have to be helped by a wheelchair. Due to the wheelchair, these people who have lost the ability to move can go from one place to another. Vehicles for transport such as motor car, train, and household appliances like air conditioner, refrigerators, water pumps, fans, and elevators used in tall buildings are all machines used in daily life. So some of the parts of such complex machines are actually simple machines. The structure of complex machines is complicated. Now from this we will define complex machines. Machines having many parts which carry out many processes of completing a task are called complex machines. In our day-to-day life, we use simple or complex machines depending upon the task to be carried out and the time and the efforts required to do it. Now, let us learn about some simple machines. First simple machine is an inclined plane. A heavy drum is to be loaded onto a truck. Ravi chose the plank A while Hami chose the plank B. Rahi did not use a plank at all. Who would find the drum heaviest to load? Who would find it lightest? Which one of the planks A and B is longer? Which one has a steeper slope? What can we conclude from this? So if a slanting plank is used to lift a weight, we have to bear. Bear means what? We have to apply less of the weight and lifting it becomes easier. So plank A is very good. Such a plank is called an inclined plane. The more gradual the slope, the lesser is the weight we bear. So if gradual slope is more, then we have to apply less weight. But such an inclined plane is what? Longer. In second case, the steeper the slope, that is in plank B, the steeper the slope, the shorter the inclined plane. But we have to bear or we have to apply a greater weight. So in plank A, we have to apply less weight and in plank B, we have to apply more weight. So plank A is easy to load any heavy load in the truck. Now children, let us do one activity, that is, let's try this. Cut out a triangle piece of paper ABC. Draw a red line along the edge AC. Roll this paper around the pencil as shown in the picture. What do you see? The inclined side AC of the triangle descends gradually from A to C. The threads on a screw are made in the same way. That is why when a screw is fitted in wood, it goes in as if it is going down an inclined plane. So this pencil is going down to an inclined plane. Therefore, less force is required to fit a screw than to hammer a nail. So we can understand we have to apply less force than to hammer a nail instead of with the help of screw. In other words, a screw is like a rolled up inclined plane made of an iron strip. Now, in case of a winding road or ghat that goes up a mountain is also like an inclined plane wrapped around the mountain. It helps big vehicles to climb up and down the mountain easy. Now observe and discuss. Two routes, namely a pathway and a road, are available to climb the mountain shown in the picture. Compare the time and strength and your convenience required to reach the mountain top. So in this case, what happens children, you have to choose any one route. One route is of pathway and another route is of road only. And you have to climb up the mountain. So in which route you will take more time and more strength? So no doubt in case of pathway, wherever there is mountain we have to climb, there you have to apply less strength and less cut. And in case of road, that road is directly you have to go in a circular manner. So in that you have to apply more strength and more time. So first means whatever pathway is there that is convenient for us to climb the mountain than the road. Now, next topic is in the past. The Greek scientist Archimedes invented the machine shown in this picture. That is why it is called the Archimedes screw. It was used to lift water from the hold of a ship. Archimedes used a round pipe fitted with a rod inside it. The pipe was placed at an angle of 45 degrees with one end inside the water and the rod resting on a flat surface. When the rod was turned, water got lifted in this device. So whenever that rod was turning, that time water was lifting in this device, and that device is called as Archimedes screw, because this screw is invented by the scientist Archimedes. Now, next type of simple machine is a fetch. When two inclined planes are joined to form a sharp tool, it is called as a wedge. An axe is used for cutting wood. A sharp tool is formed on joining two inclined planes. And such type of simple machine is called as a wedge. A wedge is used for breaking an object into two pieces or to separate objects stuck together. An axe, a knife, chisel, needle, and a nail are all the types of this wedge. That is a simple machine. Now, let us see, use your brain power. A needle is required for stitching cloth. We use knife for cutting fruit. If the tip of a needle or the edge of a knife becomes blunt, then the needle does not penetrate the cloth and the knife does not cut into the fruit. Why is this so? So, if the needle becomes blunt or the edge of the knife loses sharpness, we need to put more force while using this. So the frictional force also rises, and therefore we cannot expect the same work from this equipment. Hence the needle as well as knife will not function the way they are supposed to work. So here, whatever this sharpness is there, children, when that knife sharpness went, that is called as what? Blunt, or it is also called as dull. So when sharpness is there, how that fruit or any vegetable we can cut? And if dullness is there, then how we can cut? That we can see in this picture. I hope you all understood what is the meaning of dullness and sharpness. Thank you, children, for watching the video and for your concentration.